No, he's not picking up. I have called him twice.
Then what about the bubble suit guy then?
They weren't picking up either.
Hello?
Oh.
Brian?
Yeah?
Hi, this is Michael. I'm calling about an ATM issue you had.
Yep.
Talk to me.
Go ahead.
How can I help?
Yeah.
How can I help?
Well, the machine, my wife never got the money out of it. And she went back like 15 or 20 minutes later, and the door was closed. There was no money in it. And she withdrawal the exact same amount the second time.
Right.
She doesn't have the receipt for the first transaction, but she has it for the second. Uh-huh. On my bank statement, it shows that there were two $100 withdrawals that were back-to-back at that same ATM.
Yeah, the receipt for the second one is the one that worked, though. What about the receipt for the one that didn't work?
Well, they both worked, but she
didn't
get the receipt for the first one, but there was $100 there. And I showed that I had $100 withdrawal twice that night, but I only got $100 once on that withdrawal. And it shows on my bank statement that I withdrawal $200, but I only got $100.
Okay, because we just need
She withdrew $100 twice in a row is what happened. But she did not get the money the first time, but she got it the second.
Okay. Because we can just start a dispute for that. We just have to start a claim on that. So,
okay.
And in order to do that, on the first receipt, there'll be a transaction number and an ATM
location.
I'm telling
you, we didn't get the first $100 receipt. All I got was the second one.
What happened with the first one? Because that's going to have the transaction
information. She did not retrieve it from the machine. That was probably left behind. But if you look at the transactions, and you can see there was only a couple of them in there. There was one in between them.
It looks like you took out
$200. If you look at the sequence number, I've got a 4291 and a 4294.
Right.
But there was one in between there that there was another $100 withdrawn that we did not get the receipt for.
Okay, because I mean we've seen
this
before. Which
should have been transaction 4292.
Okay, listen.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, because you don't have a receipt, this isn't exactly a cut and dry thing. I'm just going to need to get my escalations manager in here on the call so that he can start the dispute. Because without a receipt, I don't know how I'm going to do that. And then he'll be able to pull up the account.
I've got $100 receipt, but it's the one that I retrieved the money from. But it's the other one that I'm missing, which should have been transaction 4292.
Right. And you mentioned that. So let me put you on hold. You're gonna hear some hold music, and I'm just gonna give him a quick rundown, and we'll patch him in. Okay.
Okay. All right. Appreciate it.
Okay. Thanks, Brian. 1 second.
4292 would be the one.
Your call is very important to us. Please hold.
This guy's a fucking liar for sure, dude.
Please hold.
He's a drug addict or something.
Please
hold. I bet you he's a drug addict. He'd do this all the time. He's got his dealer there, and then he gives his heroin dealer the money.
Yeah, so I'm just looking into the account for you now, Mike.
So I got, he says 4292. I swear to God, he's probably some sort of drug addict, or he doesn't know his wife's a drug addict. They're taking money out, saying they didn't get it.
She spent, $70 at a massage parlor yesterday. Did you see that?
I can't pull the account up.
Oh, I'm looking at the account now.
That's on you.
It looks like she withdrew $50 yesterday, and then she spent another $75.60 at a massage parlor.
All right, you're gonna have to talk to him because I think he's lying.
First of all,
I think they're both lying. Oh
yeah, yeah. I think he's some kind of drug addict or something. We get this shit all the time. Trust me. I'm gonna unencrypt all his bank details and send them over so you can have a look too.
All right. Thanks. I'm not allowed to pull it up, but if you can send it over, at least now we're both looking.
I've turned off all the security so you can log straight into their bank account now and have a look.
Okay. Okay.
All right. Give me a few seconds, and then patch this douchebag through to me, and I'll go through the dispute anyway. We'll see what we can do.
Douchebag.
All right, hold really? On.
Please hold. Your call is very important to us. Please hang up. Please hold. Please hold.
Hello there, sir. My name is Ron. Can I just confirm who I'm speaking with?
Yeah, it's not a drug addict. I just overheard your conversation with Joe.
Oh, I never said my
name,
sir.
My name is Brian Brink.
Yeah, we heard Brian... bag and oh, we're
yeah, bag, drug addict, and
who?
All this other stuff.
I've just come on the line.
Yeah,
I've just come onto the call, sir. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, we just overheard a whole bunch of stuff.
So we heard your call. You were talking about somebody else, obviously. It's kind of weird.
I'm not sure who you heard, okay, but I'd like to try and help you. Would you like me to do that or not?
I would like to get my $100 back from your machine.
Yeah. Right, okay. So let's take a step back. Who am I speaking with, please?
My name is Brian Drink.
Okay, Brian Drink. May I speak? Is it your wife, girlfriend, whose account
she's
it was taken
wife.
From?
She's right here with me.
I'm right here.
And she's also not a drug addict, for the record.
It's irrelevant, sir. Okay, I don't know. Need
well,
to know about
heard
that.
Well, I heard the conversation, and you're accusing us of being drug addicts.
I have just come on the call, sir. Once again, would you like me to help you or not?
Okay. Yep. All right, just stay out of it.
Yeah.
Right, what
yes.
You like
just
know?
You stay the hell out of it, Mr. Drink. Okay, ma'am. Hi. How are you doing?
I'm doing good.
Okay. Great.
Stay away.
Sir, shut up. All right, ma'am. You're gonna have to get him under control. Okay. Otherwise, I will have to terminate the call.
Wow. Okay.
Up to you. up to you, ma'am. We can get you $100 back, or your husband can keep being a douchebag. It's up to you.
Funny. Oh, I have the receipts here that I had taken out. And
okay,
I don't
so
have
can
the
you
one,
can you give me the receipt number for the $100 that wasn't taken, please?
I do not have it, but I can give you the receipt number.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay, hold on. Move my glasses on. Okay, the sequence number, the first, what happened is I meant to take $120 out.
I know. What's the number, ma'am? What's the number, ma'am?
The number of the one that I did not retrieve is 42.
Okay. Yeah. Let me look that up. If you can just shut up for a moment, let me take a look here. Okay, and just...
Show radio?
Sorry?
That'll be crazy. You're telling me to shut up for a minute. You're asking me a question.
No, I asked you the question, and then I need a bit of quiet while I type in the number. I mean, you're really not helping yourself here, ma'am. Shut up. Can you just confirm for me, to the best of your knowledge, what would the last three transactions be on that account? I just need to make sure we're looking at the same account here. So what were the last three transactions that you purchased?
I don't have all the information because my husband normally carries a card.
I can bring it up real quick.
But yeah, he can look on the account.
You're going to have to ask him to stay out of it, ma'am, okay? I know, I'm asking you. What are the last three transactions that you purchased? It's just I see...
One.
Sir, please be quiet. Stay out of this, okay? This has nothing to do with you.
This is some kind of scam.
I know, I'll make sure we're recording this. Ma'am, are you aware of a transaction at a massage parlour yesterday afternoon around 6 p.m?
No.
So that may be...
No.
Are you saying that may be fraudulent then? Because that was charged for the amount of $65.70 yesterday at around 6:15 p.m.
You got the wrong account, brother.
What is this like? Yeah, like,
yeah, you got the wrong account.
Sir,
let me have Michael back. You got the wrong account.
Sir, you need to shut up and stay out of this. I'm talking to your wife,
no,
okay?
No, you shut the fuck up. You got the wrong goddamn account. Let me have Michael back.
What's the magic word?
Fuck you. Let me have Michael back.
What's the magic word, sir?
You're
I will hang up.
You're a little British fuck. Let me have Michael back.
No.
Radio station, I swear.
I don't think Michael wants to talk to you with that filthy mouth of yours, sir. Now, if I can just carry on with your wife.
You got the filthy mouth, brother. You got the filthy mouth.
Shut up, retard. Ma'am, are you still there?
You shut the fuck up.
All right, big man. I think he was slightly annoyed. Michael, you better call back. He wants you.
Oh, he's going to call us back, dude.
You reckon?
He'll call you back.
How long before?
Of course he will.
You think he's going to call back and ask for Michael?
Right away.
All right, let's
see. Of course they are. They're not just going to let that go. There.
you called it. Are you going to answer or should I?
I will.
All right, go ahead.
Hello, this is Michael.
Hello?
Yes, this is Michael.
Michael, your British
yes,
buddy.
Sir.
This is Brian Brink. This is the guy with $100. You just told me over your little British buddy. He is one
drug addict.
Dude. I could overhear your conversation with him before you turned it over to us. And I heard him calling us drug addicts and all this other stuff. I need a new
guy. I called
you
a drug addict. No,
yeah,
I called
not
you a
drug
addict,
dude. We're not.
He
drug
called
addicts,
you a douchebag.
Okay? All I want is my $100 back that you guys kept from us. All I want is my $100. We're not drug addicts. She made a mistake when she hit the ATM. I just want my money back. There's no drug addicts,
sir,
here, all right?
Sir, sir, it, you should never physically have any kind of, like, assault with the ATM. If she assaulted the ATM, then that's going to be a problem.
She did not assault the ATM. She merely forgot
you just,
to remove
sir,
the money.
You can't sir, you me. Just said, you just said she hit the ATM.
She hit it for money. She went to the ATM. It's a figure of speech.
All right, hold on. I'm going
to
patch in my supervisor.
She went to the ATM for money. I didn't
hit it. Hold on.
She did not physically hit it. She just went to it and to get money. And your
camera's I'm patching in my supervisor. Hold on.
Okay.
I'm holding on. I hope I don't get you through.
Thank you.
That's just a joke. Hello, is Gaspian supervisor? How can I help you?
Gaspian. Talk to these people. They're getting all mad at Ron. They're mad at me. I don't know what their problem is.
Okay, hello, sir. Who is this?
Okay. Who are we speaking with?
My name is Gaspian. I am the supervisor here. How can I help you?
A supervisor.
Supervisor for who?
For the bank, sir. Well, what is the issue here, please?
Is this PNC Bank?
You would know you're speaking to us, sir. This is an incoming line only. How can I help you?
Yeah, we want to know.
Right, but I'm wondering if I'm speaking with PNC Bank.
You are wondering if you are speaking with PNC Bank. Well, yes, yes, it is correct, sir. Yes, how can I help you?
Okay.
Oh, yeah, we cannot.
We are not at the bank. We are at the corporate office, though, sir. We are corporate corporate office.
Listening. You got to shut up.
How dare you tell me? Did you just tell me to shut up?
Well, that's yeah,
because you're not listening.
And plus, the other people are telling us to shut up. We never said shut up.
That's incredibly, incredibly rude. Okay.
And things like that. And it's like, this is supposed to be a professional company?
I am a supervisor here. I have worked here for 9 years. I am extremely professional.
We've been cursed at by some
You need to change your attitude. You people need to change your attitude.
Well, we are really...
You've created our attitude because we've been cursed
You create your own attitude, sir. Now, how is it I can help you? If you could please get to the point.
Here, let me give it to you one more time.
What is it you are trying to tell me? I'm here to listen, but you are not explaining to me.
Okay, listen. We went to an ATM...
Okay, tell me what happened, please.
...and Pottstown Pike and withdrew $100... and failed to remove it from this little trap door on the bottom of the machine. My wife went back and withdrew another 100, but the money was not there, and we're just trying to retrieve the first 100 that we never got.
Yeah, that's all. And it should be in itself, and it should be recorded.
That's all we're looking for.
Okay, but why have you asked to speak to me? What is it...
I didn't have to speak. I was patched over to you.
I am a supervisor. I am not able to do this myself. You would need to speak to Michael?
Well, Michael's the one that patched me over to you.
And he's the one cursing, so I don't know.
And Michael's the one first.
No.
Michael's accusing us of being drunk.
I have worked with Michael over 5 years. I have never heard him curse at nobody. This is a terrible accusation.
Well, I've got a recording for you that you can listen to.
Well, you don't have authorization to record our voice. This is a two-party consent state, and you were committing a felony. I'm afraid I cannot continue the call if you are illegally recording me.
Well, you're recording
That's what it's all about, right? Yeah, we're committing a felony.
Yes, no, it's a two-party consent state.
If you're committing a felony by stealing our money.
Well, call the police then, dickhead.
See, you just said, really? That's not professional. How did you become a manager?
It's called education. It's called education, mommy. Something you will never know.
You need to get one, brother.
Okay. Yeah, you need to get a job, sir. Okay.
Yeah.
he hung up. I bet he calls back for Michael. I forgot about that, Isidore. You stupid woman. I'm gonna call him back. And do you want to answer as Hot Dog Mike or Steven or anybody? I'll let you choose.
Hot Dog Mike. Mike, how you doing? What do you want? BNC.
Who's this?
Hot Dog Mike.
That got rid of him quickly.